Okay guys, welcome to another tutorial in the Django tutorial series 2. In the last video or in the last tutorial we saw how to basically display or have the map with data on the front end. In this video I want to show you how we could customize some of the problems that we faced in the last video and also some of the issues that I'll show you that usually happen. And I can basically help you on tackling how we can handle them. So for example, here when you're adding the county, you can see whatever is happening here. Same case when adding a shop. So whatever is happening is because we are on HTTP, but the data that is coming in, or the tiles, are expected to come in as HTTPS. So basically, we are getting the allow origin issue. So there are quite a number of ways in which you can do this. If you are to host this application in a server basically running under SSL or the HTTPS, you could basically find that this issue will disappear and your tiles will basically load. Personally, for my liking, I don't usually use the normal OSM geoadmin because of the tools that exist and the flexibility. And because really in the, our application here, we've already installed Django Leaflet. So I think what, we've not installed it. Okay, let me check. So we could basically just use Leaflet directly. Just to have a better interface, so I can see it's not installed. So to install Leaflet, it's basically Django Leaflet. So on my applications, mostly as much as I do not like having third party applications, I usually for the mapping up libraries or packages, I usually use the Leaflet a lot, because it gives a lot of flexibility in terms of the tools, drawing the features and all that. And now because our application actually has polygons, it will be a perfect fit for our use case. So let me just do this. Please, let me just create a requirement files, requirement.txt file. Okay, yeah, so now I get the, I get a file with requirements. All right, so let's move on. So basically, what we need to do is, now that we've installed Leaflet, we just need to add it here, Leaflet, like that. Oh, there's a comma here. So with that, we can basically, so Django Leaflet, usually, if you look at its documentation, usually gives you a number of ways in which you can customize your Leaflet implementation within your application, and there's usually some specifications that you can have. So I just want to add some configs here. These are basically from Leaflet. These are, you can actually check the documentation. All right. So the first is the first thing is basically the center. You remember the way we just created the maps here? We define the center, the zoom level, the center layers, and all that. So here, Leaflet configuration gives you options to change quite a number of things. You can change the minimum zoom. For example, if I was to use a minimum zoom, min zoom. We could probably say we want 2. I could have a center, center here. So a center again, we could define what basically we had here. If you wanted to maybe be focused in Kenya. So there's one, there's one thing that I need to, so ideally when you load this component, for example, when you're adding a new shop, this map by default, you'll find that it falls, like it zooms to the entire world. So this directive here, or this option, zooms or make sure that when the map is loading, it actually zooms to the center. So if you are not dealing with the entire world, you can actually specify an area in which you want the data to be zoomed to. Sorry, not the data, but the map. This actually is not square bracket. It should be that. And then we have the minimum zoom. We can, of course, have a maximum zoom. So maximum zoom here can be directed by the base map that you will add. So for example, most of them range between 19 and 22 there. So for example, if I was to basically do that, if I refresh this, there's nothing yet that will happen. I'm pretty probably sure you get why it's not happening. We need to change the admin file here. So we need to import. So this is from leaflet dot admin. We need to import leaflet geo admin. Okay, and then now we can have this instead of having, for example, under the shop, instead of having the OSM one, the OSM admin. We could actually replace all this with that. Okay, so now if I try to refresh the page, bingo, my map now changes and I can see a number or a couple of tools here. It seems a bit pretty, but I can see there's nothing to show at the back because we are still trying to load the same base maps that we basically had. The good thing with this option or this leaflet admin, we could basically define our own tiles that we could actually use. For example, the tiles that we had here, this one here, that one, we could, where's my settings file? We could basically come here and just specify that. We want that as a tile. So a tile there. And this option gives you, or this part, you have an option to define a number of tiles. Okay, so there you are. And if I refresh the map, woohoo, I can see error not resolved. I know why. It's Google on some issues. Let me just do this. Let me revert. I just want to copy whatever error that it was giving us. So I need to copy the OpenStreetMap one. So the OpenStreetMap base map, you could actually reference. Let me see whether I can find it. Yeah, we could just add that tile here. Tiles, and then I have that. All right. So now instead of HTTPS, you could even use HTTPS or even HTTP like that. And if I reload my map, I should see. Oh, what is happening to this part? Let me see. Woohoo. Let me see. Sorry. Oh yeah, it's loaded. So now, because I've basically specified the tile, so now it's loading this tile. Remember, our point was at the center of the ocean, so that's why it's all here. And now, because I have leaflet admin, I could easily actually edit this point and move it to Kenya like that. And I save, and now my map, I should see my point in Kenya there. Okay, it's pretty simple on some of these elements, but it's something in terms of usability, it could be hectic if you do not know how to maneuver around this stuff. So just by changing one definition and everything on our admin has worked. Of course, there are other packages that you can install, such as map widgets. which basically gives you Google Base Maps, and it's usually much better. But for that one is usually when you're dealing with a lot of point data, that's when you can actually go for map widgets. But for when you're dealing with lines, you're dealing with polygons and points, all that kind of mixture, Leaflet GeoAdmin serves the purpose. The other thing is, when you look at this map here, there's one problem, and this problem is basically if you zoom out completely, you're basically seeing a number of panes. And if you'll see whatever the one that was on focus is the one that basically the marker is on. So meaning if someone was to zoom into this area, and it's continuous actually, and you zoom to Africa or Kenya, basically the marker is not there. So to avoid such a thing in your maps, you could basically define the extent into which the map is displayed. And that extent, you could actually define it directly here within the definition of the map component. And how you identify the what we call the bounds or the extent is basically by picking, it will depend on how you want to define it, but for me, it's basically like you define the most northeast or eastern part, and then the southern western part. So that bit will basically restrain the map to those bounds, and you'll not have an issue like this on your application. So to do that, let me just show you very fast. So you could actually so how you define bounds within let me just define them like that. So you can define bounds based on there are quite a number of ways in which you can define the bounds. So I'll just show you a number or one that I've used for quite some time, and it did works. So something like that. So lat long bounds, and of course we define the latitudes and the longitudes. So here we can have maybe F1 and F2, or let me just call B1 and B2. But this B1 and B2, we need to define them. These are basically the extent. So I could have B1. So the B1 here is basically, we can start with with the southwest. So here we just need, it's a couple of it's a point. So we have lat long, and then here you could basically have a point. So this should be capital L. So how do we get the southern? So we need this point, for example, or somewhere here. We do not need to show the white part, somewhere here. So to get those coordinates, we could easily go to Maps. Could easily go to Google Maps. So for example, for me, I'm in Nairobi, or I'm in Kenya. So I could probably restrain the map to Kenya. If we were dealing with the whole Africa, we could restrain the application to Africa. And if we are dealing with the world, we could basically use the entire world. So for example, let me just show you how to basically restrict within like the globe. So we could basically pick a location like this. Or if I want to just show Africa, I can pick a location like this. So this is Southwest. So I have the coordinates here. I can just copy that there, and I just paste them here, and then I could define B2, which is L dot lat long, like that. And I could just pick the northeastern part, which I could basically point somewhere like here, like that. Allow me to copy. Okay, it's not allowing me to copy. Let me just copy it directly, like that. Okay, so now I have my, this is basically southwest, and then this one is basically northeast. Okay, so now I have my B1, B2, and if I refresh my map on this side, let's see what happens. I have an error. Let me see. L is not defined. Sorry. Typos. Okay. There you are. And so, I forgot to add it here. So I need to add the bounds from this side. My bad. So I need to add the bounds. Then I can reference the bounds that we have here. Okay. So now we have the map there. Still it's not working. Why? No, this should not be this should be max bounds, I guess. Let me, yeah, I'm assuming so. I hope I got it correctly. Not really. So now it's zooming itself to, did I define very huge? I think I gave a very huge bound. Let me just check why this is happening. Center that, max. Okay, let me just do this to just easy things. So max zoom, I can have maybe 18. I think this is at 22, so I can just have 22, and the mean zoom to be 4, the one that we defined here. So let me see. It worked. So now you see, if I look at my map here, so let me just add, I could add the height, so I could just maybe have 800, so we can see the entire of Africa. So I cannot go beyond or below this zoom level. And now if I try to go beyond the point that we defined, my map is now restricted, and I'm able to ensure that anyone who uses this map will not have another pane showing another pane of the world with no data. Now they just be restricted to this window, and they'll have to see all the data set. So that's how you are able to restrict the map based on a certain extent or a certain bound. And as you can see, it's not pretty, it's pretty easy. And of course, these are some useful elements when using a map or when creating an application, which the users will have difficulties in trying to use if they're not implemented. So that's it, guys. Cheers.